Hi friends, my name is Akil Ahmed and in this particular video tutorial I will show you how to install MySQL on Windows machine. So I am planning to do some migration videos from other sources to MySQL, like from migrating data from SQL Server or CSV file to MySQL Server database, and similarly I am planning to do some video tutorials on migrating data from MySQL to SQL Server and from MySQL to CSV files and text files, etc. So this is our first video tutorial on installing MySQL on the Windows machine. So this is my profile. I have 13 plus years of experience. So the agenda of today's video tutorial is how to install MySQL on the Windows machine. So let's jump to the demo. First of all, you need to open any web browser. I have just opened the Chrome, and then in the Google you can just simply type download MySQL, and you can open this first website mysql.com and click on this one, downloads MySQL. So as soon as this website has been opened, you can just scroll down and there is an option MySQL community GPL download. So you can click on this one, and then there are some options here like MySQL installer for Windows. So you can just click on this one. So there are two installers, MSI installer whose size is 2.4 MB and the second one is whose size is 470 MB. If you download the first one, so it will try to download rest of the files as soon as you will start the installation. However, if you install the second one, so everything is included in the second one. Suppose if you are working on a server where you have some restrictions on like on using firewall or something, so you might have issues doing the installation using the first one because your server firewalls may block some of the downloads. So usually I prefer installing this one because everything is included in this particular download file. So I will click on this download, and now I can click on no thanks, just start my download. So it will download the 470 MB file to my machine, and then we can further proceed with the installation. So the installation file has been downloaded, and to start the installation I can just click on this one and it is started. So a new pop-up will get opened. Maybe I can just minimize this one. So this particular window will get opened up. So there are some options like developer default, server only, client only, full and custom. So I will go with custom because I want to just do some migration and maybe I can write some SQL queries as well. So I can just click next, and now from the MySQL servers I'll expand this, and then I will select this MySQL 8.0 and I will add it to the products to be installed. Now under applications I will select MySQL Workbench. It is similar to SSMS, so I will select this one as well, and then I will select this shell as well. If you want to use shell, then you can use this one as well. And I think that's it for now. For connectors I will create another video, like what connectors are required for migration using SSI. So for this one I will select only these three components. So this is MySQL server, which is similar to the SQL server you can think of, and this is MySQL workbench, which is similar to SSMS, and this is MySQL shell. So in the shell you can write the queries in a command prompt window. So I have just selected these three components, so, and I can click on next. Now these three components are ready to be installed, so I can just click on execute to get them installed. Alright, so the installation is complete. I can click now on next. Now the MySQL server status is ready to configure, so you can click on next. So you can leave all the settings as it is. The port number used by the MySQL is 3306. So I can click on next. Now it is asking to use a strong password encryption for authentication. So I can click on next. And here I need to give the password for the MySQL user. So the default MySQL user is root, and that's password I'm going to provide. So maybe I can provide MySQL123. MySQL123, and I can click next. I can leave all the settings as it is, and I can click next, and then I need to click on the execute. So now I can click on finish, and I can click next and I can click on finish now. So the MySQL server has been installed on your machine, and this is the shell that we install, and this is the MySQL workbench. Okay, so maybe I can close this one and I can just open the MySQL workbench. So I can type MySQL. There's an option MySQL workbench 8.0, so I can click on this one, and maybe I can maximize this window, and we need to click on local instance MySQL. So as soon as you will click on this one, this window will pop up and you need to type the password for the root user that we gave, MySQL 123, and I can click on this one, save password in vault. So I can just click on this one and click OK. So this particular window will get opened up. So if you click on schema, so they are actually the databases. So if you refresh all, so these are, right now there are no databases, and only there is a sys database here. So to create a database, you can just simply write create database, maybe I can put test, and then you can click on this one to create test database. So you can see that create database test, it got executed successfully. And now if you right click here and click on refresh all, so you will see the test database here, and under test database you can create some tables and store procedures, functions, views, etc. Now suppose if you want to execute a query against test database, or you want to create a new table inside the test database, then you can simply write use test semicolon, and then you can write any query here. That query will actually get executed on the test database. So this is how you can install the MySQL on your Windows machine. In future you will see more videos migrating data to MySQL or exporting data from MySQL to other destinations. Thank you guys for watching the video, and if you like the video then please click the like button, do subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon and click on all so that you will be notified every time I upload a new video. Thank you so much.